What's up? Good morning, everybody. It is the middle of June, Father's Day weekend. Happy Father's Day to all of you men out there. I am getting ready to do some work outside. It's about 7 in the morning, and it's supposed to be 100 degrees here in Central Florida, so I gotta get busy. Let's get to it.
Did some fertilizing to my peppers. I'm gonna use some fish fertilizer as well, only because I'm starting to notice what looks like some blossom end rot on my peppers. So I'm gonna go ahead and take this one off. I've got more banana peppers coming, so not too worried about that. Some shishito peppers. I like to use organic Neptune's Harvest fish fertilizer. It's really good. It is stinky, but it's good. Ooh, Samson. This is not for you. And I'm just using a capful. This is about a half a gallon container. All right, now that I'm done with that, I am going to add some water to my green stuff. For my green stock, I like to add a little bit at a time. So it has fill lines. If I pull it all the way to the top, it'll just run right back out of the green stock. But I'll fill it halfway, and then I'll come back to it in about an hour.
All right, so now I'm gonna water all the stuff over here. Boy, Samson. As you know, I live in Zone 9, Central Florida. And it is going to be 100 degrees today, which is pretty high for June. So I want to make sure everything gets like water. Heat index said 110, which is insane. It is already 80 degrees and it is 7 in the morning. Which is why I still have on my pajamas. Because I wanted to hurry up and get out here and get stuff done. Before it gets too hot to do anything. In the summertime, I usually water pretty much every day for my containers. Some of the big pots are still moist. So, all right, let's water outside. All right, we are now outside. I'm gonna get ready to water, but I wanted to prune some of these tomato leaves that are looking a bit diseased. They don't have a lot of airflow. That one belongs there. What I found. So we're just gonna take him. This is a hornworm. They get very big. So I'm just gonna set him here. We've got a lot of birds in the area. I'm sure they'll appreciate the snack. It's important you keep good airflow. Good thing I'm out here pruning, otherwise I wouldn't have seen him. Prune off any suckers. It's pretty hot. Tomato season is pretty much done. Wrapping up here for Central Florida, at least the bigger tomatoes. If you're growing cherry tomatoes, they can last a lot longer. Everything else is looking good. My blueberries are doing okay. They get a lot of shade from this sugar cane here, which is growing massive. Leave that alone. It's important that you do your trimming and stuff before you water. You don't really want to do it after you water, because then it encourages the spread of disease, which is what we don't want. So the leaves that I'm removing, just so I can show you guys, are starting to get discolored, starting to get spots and stuff like that. So you want to remove those.
Let's actually tuck him into the cage. Okay, for now, let's look at all of these peppers. Can you guys see them? So many peppers. This one has a lot of peppers as well. Okra is doing well. My poor little calendula is just getting too hot. All right, whew, starting to sweat. I also think I'm gonna harvest these potatoes today. Need to find something, a tarp or something, do a potato harvest. Let's do that first. Oops, some potatoes started to attach themselves. Three nice sized potatoes and two little ones. So that's exciting. All right, I'm just putting the dirt back in here. I'm going to eventually amend this and use it for something else. All right, I'm gonna let my sweet potatoes grow and do their thing. Whew. All right, I am back, and it is getting really hot. All right, I've cleaned off my pruners. I see some tomatoes that I kind of, do I want to harvest these? Are you ready? Almost. I think I'm gonna let them go. Nope. I'm gonna take it, but oh, that spider web. Alright. Look how good my chocolate mint is doing out here. This I transplanted. It's doing so well. Except for that weed. Let's get you out of there. These are the Heatmaster tomatoes. This is the one that volunteered. Again, it's crazy how it produced way more than the one that I actually planted. Barely get to stuff. All right. Woo! All right, I think that's it for today. Society garlic, blossoming again, so pretty. I've removed the head of my sunflower. It is drying on the inside. One little baby blossom, not sure if you can see it, on my pink Eureka lemon tree. Let's see if it holds it, but it's put on so much new growth. These variegated leaf patterns are just absolutely gorgeous. So Myers lemon pretty much not doing anything but growing its leaves back. So no blossoms. Let's do some watering. Again, it's going to be really hot today, so I want to make sure everything gets nice and saturated. If I were planting in the ground, I would heavily mulch everything. Keep the ground moist, but I'm not. I am in containers, so it's very important that when you have containers, you don't let them dry out, because they're going to dry out a lot quicker than plants in the ground would.
you guys can see how much I'm sweating. It is not even 8 a.m. Tomato. I think it's doing so well because its roots is really shaded. And also the ground stays pretty moist back there. Because it's still putting on tons of blossoms. If you look at all the blossoms on this compared to the one that I planted, that's pretty much done. No blossoms. Getting ready to take this and throw it in the trash. You don't want to compost it. It does look like it's got some kind of either fungus or bacterial infection from the spots on the leaves. So I'm going to take that along with my tomato branches and throw it in the garbage, not the compost. All right, while we are inside, now that I'm done outside, just want to show you guys, I had to move my pepper seedlings in my little mini greenhouse. They were getting too hot and burnt and started looking like that one there. So lost a few, as you can tell. But I do think I saved the rest. They are doing well now that I moved them in the greenhouse. My thorny, what I'm assuming is a raspberry, could be a blackberry, I don't know. It was one of those freebies that came when I purchased my strawberries. Looks like they're putting on some blossoms. So I may actually get some fruit this year. That's exciting. I'm gonna update all three bulbs that I planted of the lilies, the tiger lilies, have sprouted and are doing well, so that is exciting. My little zinnia that is growing all kinds of wonky, trying to get some sun, is hanging in there. I don't know, my okra is trying. It's trying to hang in there. Marigold is doing well down there. My pepper plant that blossomed is doing okay. The little blossom looks like it's starting to turn yellow, so it'll probably fall off, but it's got more blossoms on there. Look how tall the serrano peppers got. So we'll see if it actually does anything. I think it's all still reaching for the sun. This is my other jalapeno that is trying. My Heatmaster, it's getting nice and big. There's my hand for comparison. Just doesn't get a lot of sun, so it's very slow to ripen. This one, I don't know what's going on with it, but the flesh looks really weird. My bean plant is starting to finally fizzle out. I've got a few beans left on here that I'm trying to dry out. The royal burgundy hasn't put on any beans. It's been way too hot. Whatever blossoms that it does have usually dry out and die. So basil plant doing well. It's getting just enough sun to produce. I have my gypsy pepper over there. I harvested one earlier in the week. Lots of shishito peppers coming in. And then lots of banana peppers and flowers. All right, it's getting hot out here, guys. All right, guys, it's hot. I'm starting to glisten. So hope you guys have a beautiful Father's Day. Don't forget to like and subscribe, and I'll catch you guys later. Love you. Bye.